Today, I will introduce a new model that generates videos using pose information. This model is called Scale. The biggest feature of this model is the introduction of a new pose representation method called NLF pose. Unlike traditional open pose and DW open pose, this pose is a 3D pose. Therefore, it can accomplish a wide variety of functions. I have designed 9 test scenarios. First, similar to traditional models for video generation from poses, we provide an image and a driving video, and it can generate an excellent video. Furthermore, it performs very well in terms of facial consistency. It also features pose alignment. This means that if the pose in our driving video and the pose in our reference image are not exactly the same, the generated pose will automatically align to our reference image. The resulting video is still impeccable. Since the NLF pose format includes facial information, it can, to a certain extent, drive some facial variations. In the generated video, we can also see the performance regarding facial consistency. In addition to this, it can also generate ultra-long videos. For example, when I generated 161 frames, you can see that the resulting output is excellent in terms of pose consistency, color representation, and overall composition. Moreover, there is no flickering in the middle. Furthermore, South Carolina AIL addresses a notoriously difficult problem in video generation, which is video involving rotation. You will find that its performance is still very accurate, but it doesn't stop there. Not only can it perform pose transfer, but it can also control camera movement. For example, look at our reference video. At the beginning, it has a camera rotation animation. Using the scale model, we can perfectly reproduce this camera rotation animation. This is something that other models are almost incapable of achieving. Therefore, it is no exaggeration to say that the scale model is the best performing model in the entire field of pose transfer. What you are seeing now is the scale page on GitHub. We can see that Kijai's Wang Video extension already supports this model. Due to the importance of the NLF pose, Kijai specifically developed an extension to extract and render the NLF format pose. If you want to use this model, you only need to update the One Video extension to the latest version. Then, we can find the scale workflow in the example workflows. You can simply drag and drop it into your ComfUI. Regarding model download, Kijai still provides 2 formats. The first is BF16, and the second is FP8. You can select a different model based on your computing power. I have also built the workflow on Running Hub. You can access this platform through Running Hub. In the ComfUI field, Running Hub is an excellent online workspace. This is because whenever a new extension or new technology emerges, Running Hub follows up immediately. You can register for Running Hub using the invitation link in my video description, which will grant you 1,000 free credits. Additionally, you receive 100 bonus points every day you log into Running Hub, allowing you to try out your own workflows. Next, we will use 9 workflows to introduce this model in detail. First, let's look at the most basic usage of this model. Since this is a pose reference generation model, we need a driving video and a reference image here. Regarding the selection of the reference image, I am currently trying to keep it aligned with the driving video. Next, we need to extract the overall pose. But you must note that the format is NLF. At this point, we need to install another extension from Kijai. Take a look. This extension is called ComfUI Scale Pose. Only then will you be able to access the nodes we are currently using. Look at these nodes. They are relatively simple to use. First is the pose extraction. This pose extraction is very interesting. It actually converts vid pose into DW open pose. Therefore, it loads a model here because this node has a built-in download function. If the model does not exist, it will automatically download it. It then uses our Vite pose and the Yolov 10 model. This combination method has already been seen in some of Kijai's pose extraction nodes. By utilizing these models, we can extract the poses of the video and the reference image. However, note that the extracted pose is DW pose and its output is JSON data. The node we use at this time is called RenderNLFPose. The function of this node is multifaceted. First, it can perform pose alignment. This is because the inputs required here are firstly the pose of the first frame. We use NLF predict to detect the pose of the first frame. This pose is naturally in the NLF format. The pose from our video is connected to the DW pose input, and the pose from our reference image is connected to the reference DW pose input. Through these three nodes, we can align the extracted pose of the driving video to our reference image. This is the first function of this node. The second function is to convert the pose format. As you can see, the two inputs here are both DW pose, but what we ultimately need is an NLF pose. Therefore, it converts the DW pose into the NLF format. Furthermore, there is a rendering function. It can render the JSON format data into an image and display it to us. Next, let's look at the main model loading here. We load the scale FP8 model. We use the latent X to V acceleration model, enabling block swapping. The number of block swaps is set to 25. We also load the 2.1 VAN hour visual model. This next part is for our text prompt. I wrote a very simple prompt, a beautiful dancing girl. The following section is one of the more crucial elements in the entire workflow because we are ultimately generating an image embedding vector. How is this embedding vector obtained? First, we use the visual model to encode the reference image. Then we generate an empty image embedding vector, which can also be interpreted as generating an empty latent. Then we will use two nodes. The usage of these two nodes is actually the same as in SteadyDancer. First, we add the reference image to our latent. Then we add the extracted pose to our latent. This latent will be used during the subsequent sampling process. Next is the sampling section. Kijai has specifically developed a sampler node, which they now call VV. This node includes some optimizations. It places some essential inputs for sampling directly into this node. Other content is placed in the extra parameters input. First is our scheduler. We use the 6-gen step sampling, and the shift value is set to 7.0 in the extra properties option. We enable context option. Essentially, this has a sliding window property, which allows for the generation of ultra-gen long videos. Then, we perform the sampling to obtain the final result. We did not use a resolution of 480x82, because if you look closely at the scale model, its resolution is 512p, not 480p. Everyone should note that the final resolution we generate must be divisible by 32. Traditional WAN models, on the other hand, usually only need to be divisible by 16. This is the final generated result. First, let's look, the pose transfer is fine, and the alignment to the reference image is also fine. Moreover, the character consistency is extremely strong. We can compare the character in the generated video and the character in the reference image. They are very similar. This is the simplest workflow for scale. The second workflow is actually the same as the first. We are just testing whether the sliding window mechanism is effective. Look at the length of my video here. It is very long. I extracted 161 frames from it, which is almost 10 seconds of video. Let's look at the final generated result. It is excellent. Of course, you can increase the length of the generated video and test how long a video it can actually generate. Next, let's look at pose alignment. This is because when selecting the driving video and the reference image, we cannot guarantee that the viewing angles of the two are completely consistent. For example, my current video is a full body shot, while my reference image is a half body shot. At this point, pose alignment is necessary. The workflow we showed you includes a built-in pose alignment function. The final pose we generate has been aligned to the reference image, which is a half body shot, just like the reference image. Let's look at the generated result. The effect is very beautiful. The character consistency is also very good, and the motion transfer is excellent. Furthermore, it performs pose alignment. Therefore, compared to SteadyDancer or One-to-All animation, its overall effect is indeed much better. This next workflow is used to test its control over facial expressions. As we all know, the NLF format comes with facial data. Therefore, my driving video uses a relatively close-up perspective, so we can clearly see the person's face. The reference image also uses a relatively close-up perspective. Now, let's look at the final generated result. The overall motion transfer is perfect. However, the facial expressions, I wouldn't say they aren't transferred at all, but they are not particularly detailed, because if you look closely at the pose data, although there are facial movements, they are not particularly clear. Since NLF pose is a 3D format pose, let's test whether it can perfectly generate a video involving rotation. The driving video shows a beautiful girl standing on a drone, performing a 360-degree rotation. For the reference image, I chose a girl standing in the water. First, let's look at the extracted pose. That is not a problem. Then, let's look at the generated video. You may be very pleasantly surprised to find that this model can perfectly represent this kind of rotation movement. As we mentioned before, other models can hardly achieve this function. Moreover, you should note that based on the generated result, it also seems to support some camera movements. We can see the effect of camera movement both in the final video and in the pose video we obtained. Next, let's see if it can explicitly control camera movement. This is also a driving video we used before. This video initially has a camera rotation animation. We also used the reference image before. Let's look at the generated result. Notice that the focus is still on the character rotating, right? The camera did not rotate. I originally thought the test might end here, but I was unwilling to give up, so I added a Uni3C node. Look, we encode the driving video we just used into our latent. Then we use Uni3C to extract its camera motion and connect it to our Uni3C embed input. At this point, you will find that we have perfectly solved the problem of camera rotation. Through these numerous workflows and sample tests, haven't you noticed that the scale model seems to be an omnipotent model? It can do everything, and that is indeed the case. Therefore, I recommend everyone thoroughly test it, okay? That is all for today. Follow me to become an AI expert.